Let's discuss an important concept of charge induction in concentric metal shells. Let's consider a situation when there are two concentric metal shells, which are say of radii A and B. Now we'll generalize our concept for two shells, two concentric shells, and later we can use it on any number of shells. Say these are two shells A and B of radii A and B, and say only a charge plus Q is given to the inner shell and no other charge is given anywhere else. So in this situation we can say due to mutual repulsion, this charge will spread on the outer surface of shell A and it will originate a total flux from the charge will be Q by epsilon naught, and this flux will be originated out. And we know well that electric lines can never penetrate a metal surface because inside a metal always electric field is zero. So due to this positive charge, free electrons of the shell B will be pulled inside and some negative charge will be induced on the inner surface of shell B, on which the flux will start terminating. And as we know that no electric line can penetrate the shell B, that means whole of the flux will terminate on the inner surface of the shell. That means the total induced charge on the inner surface must be exactly equal to minus Q, because the flux Q by epsilon naught is being absorbed by the surface, and as shell B is neutral, an equal charge, equal and opposite charge plus Q will induce on the outer surface, because the total charge of shell B should be zero and it will originate further the flux Q by epsilon naught, which will go to infinity like this. So here you can see that on the inner surface of the metal shell B, exactly an equal charge will be induced, which will be able to absorb whole of the flux which is originated from the outer surface of the inner shell A. A similar concept we can discuss in a different situation. When both of these shells are given charges, like if we consider a situation when again there are two concentric metal shells, which here you can see I'm drawing, this is shell A, this is shell B, and these are of radii A and B. Now a charge plus Q1 is given to the inner shell and plus Q2 is given to the outer shell. Then in this situation we can say that the inner shell will produce a total flux of Q1 by epsilon naught in outward direction, because due to mutual repulsion, whole of its charge will reside on the outer surface. And we know as B is also a metal shell, whole of its flux will also terminate on the inner surface of the shell. So in this situation, we can say that an equal charge minus Q1 will induce on the inner surface of the shell B, and a charge plus Q1 will induce on the outer surface of shell B. So if we talk about the total charges on inner and outer surface of shell B, here we can say on the inner surface the charge will be minus Q1 exactly, which will be able to absorb the total flux, exactly the total flux which is originated by the outer surface of inner shell. And on the outer surface, its total charge will be Q2 plus Q1, because Q2 is the charge which originally shell B was containing, and plus Q1 will be an additional induced charge due to the induction effects by the shell A. So in the final situation, after complete charge distribution, we can see that on shell A inner surface, there will not be any charge. On the outer surface, the total charge is Q1. And on the inner surface of shell B, it is minus Q1, and on its outer surface, it is Q2 plus Q1. And here we can write that initial charge on shell A will be plus Q1, and initial charge on shell B was plus Q2. And after final distribution on different surfaces, these will be the charges which we have discussed. Now in the similar fashion, what we have discussed here, you can generalize the concept for any number of shells, any number of concentric shells, but always remember that on any shell, inner surface, the charge will be equal and opposite to that of the charge which will be on the outer surface of its immediate inner shell.